మేడం చెప్పండి.
ఇది ఏదో శ్రీధర్ పెట్టాడు, ఏంటది 6, 7 to 8 రీషెడ్యూల్ అయిందని. మన వాళ్ళకి కూడా ఉందా?
ఆ 3rd year కే మేడం.
అంటే వాళ్ళు దే కుడెంట్ జాయిన్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దట్ అప్ టు 6 o'clock అన్నది, ఇప్పుడు 7 to 8 అయిందా?
ఆ అంతే అనుకో.
అయితే మనం 7 కి అందరూ ఉంటారా? మనం క్లోజ్ చేయాలా 7 కి? పర్వాలేదా,
వీలైతే క్లోజ్ చేద్దాం మేడం.
ఓకే,
లేకపోతే వాళ్ళు రీషెడ్యూల్ చేసుకుంటాం.
నేను రెడీ విత్ మై బుక్. యా శ్రవంతి, అయ్యో చేస్తున్నా ఆగు.
ఓకే మేడం, నో ప్రాబ్లం. ఐ స్టార్టెడ్ ద రికార్డింగ్ మేడం. ఐ మీకు లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ కార్నర్ కి రికార్డింగ్ అని వస్తుందా?
వస్తాం.
ఓకే, జస్ట్ కీప్ ఎన్ నో నో జస్ట్ కీప్ ఎన్ ఐ ఆన్ ఇట్ అంతే. అండ్ ద లెఫ్ట్
నిన్న అది రాలేదంటావా?
సో యు ఆర్ గెట్టింగ్ ఇట్ ఆన్ ద లెఫ్ట్ కార్నర్ రైట్?
వస్తాం వస్తాం.
టాప్ కార్నర్, లెఫ్ట్ కార్నర్ టైప్.
యా
ఇన్ రెడ్ అండ్ వైట్.
yes,
జస్ట్ కన్ఫర్మింగ్.
చెప్తాను ఇన్ కేస్ ఐ మిస్ దట్, ఎప్పుడైనా అది పోతే చూపు చెప్తా.
Madam, please tell whether my audio is proper or it has some disturbance, madam.
Okay, I'll interrupt if it is, if there is any problem.
Okay.
Can start in 5 to 10 minutes. Let there be at least around 50.
Okay.
Yes, good evening, one and all. Pragati, mute your device.
23. Ma'am, I guess like 60 is a good count to start with.
Yes, you can start.
Yes, we can start, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Otherwise, it will go beyond 7.
Yes, ma'am. So, before we start, special thanks to Amitesh for yesterday's recording, which we missed. Today, the recording is on. Nothing to worry, I guess. It comes over here, this left corner. If someone can spot it missing, then you can immediately switch on your mic and report. Yes. So today it is a lab session, and you are supposed to install JMeter and keep it ready. I kept this video for that. I don't know how many of you have JMeter installed. Yes, of course, we understand that some of you are at hometowns and you don't have laptops. So for them especially, we have these two videos along with which the session which will be recorded. Okay, our session which will be recorded. So these two videos have some basics. Okay, now today's session will be a kind of repetition of these two videos, but I'll go with the basics because I've watched these two videos. Some points are missing, like what is load and stress was not conveyed properly. That is what I feel, okay, from my students' point of view and my point of view. So I'll be covering that part of load and stress. Okay. So we'll start off. So I hope your JMeter is ready. So this is your JMeter. I hope my screen is being displayed to all of you. I hope. Yeah, thank you, yeah. Now, why are students chatting their roll numbers and names? I don't know why you are doing this. Achha. Okay, if you chat attendance, oh, got the point. I have a tool actually over here. I'll just show you. It's good that in the chat you mention, but I don't think, see, this is your roll number and this is your name. You can just say good evening, sir, and of course your name and roll number will be included, and we'll have a greeting for us, an evening greeting for us instead of
thing they do for other subjects, sir. So I think there's a routine they are following the same.
Achha, they're following a routine. Okay. No problem. I just show you that we have a I'm using a extension over here which is recording the attendance. So this is how we get the attendance.
Irrespective of their answer, of their chat.
Yeah, this extension is recording everything, your attendance, whoever joins. So, but still, it's a good practice, nothing wrong. But instead of keeping your roll number and name, yeah, this was required by Nikita Reddy because her roll number and name was, okay, Yarvish, up to you, it's good. Anyway, good. Okay. Yeah. Back to my JMeter. So this is how your J meter looks. Okay, my J meter looks like this on Linux. In Windows, I guess the new version has a different theme or dark mode or something. Okay, but before we go further with J meter, you need to understand why J meter. Okay, why J meter or what does it do? What actually is load and stress testing? Okay, so this is a very important point which you need to know. Load and stress, both are tied up together. Load and stress are points which are tied up together. So what is load and what is stress, we'll see. Okay, so for that I'm going to take an example. This is just an example. This is a physical example. Okay, nothing to do with software. We'll map it with software. So imagine I have a car and I have a truck. I have a car and I have a truck. Okay. Now, which goes fast? You just tell me which goes fast. So of course, all of you will tell that car goes fast, the truck goes a little bit slow. Okay, very good. Now I'll post a condition. Okay, I'll post a condition. So condition I'm keeping in brackets. So imagine that I'm adding, imagine 800 kilos. It's like 1 ton. Not 800 kilos, I guess. Ma'am, 1,000 kilos is a ton. So I'm adding 1 ton to the car and 1 ton to the truck. So let me tell you what is 1 ton. So 1 ton is like 10 people sitting in the car. Okay, approximately. If each person's weight is 100 kgs, 10 people sitting in a car. So which goes fast? Which goes fast? The truck goes fast or the car goes fast? Yeah, again, that's a question. Again, sir, are we talking about a SUV? Then also you can tell that, okay, it's an SUV, it can carry 10 passengers. So the car goes fast and the truck goes slow. Okay, very good. Now, what about I add 10 tons? This time I'll add 10 tons. I'll add 10 tons. Now you tell me, will the car even move? Forget about fast and slow. Will a car even move? No. That means what? That means what? You have loaded it too much. You have loaded it too much. Okay. Whereas a truck, of course, it goes slow because it's meant to go slow. Not meant to go slow. It goes. It moves. It can take that load. Okay, now see, this is the braking point of the car. Please understand, this is the braking point of the car. So 10 tons is a braking point of the car. It cannot take the load. That means it cannot even move a single inch with that 10 tons. Okay, so that is what is, we call it as load testing. Okay, that is what is called as load testing. I load it. I tell it to move, it can't move. So that is the weight. That is the weight. So I don't directly add 1,000 tons. I'll add a ton, 2 tons, 3 tons, 4 tons. And I find out that at 10 tons, it has a breaking point. Okay. Now, let me change this to 5 tons. Let me change this. I'll change it to 5 tons. Now tell me, what will happen to the car? 5 tons of load. 5 tons is like 50 people. So imagine it is a, like all of you know, Tufan, right? There's a car which is SUV, Tufan, right? You'll be seeing it at Sagar X Road. You know many places where buses can't reach properly, these vehicles are used. So imagine 50 people in Tufan. Okay, it will go, but now, it will go slow, whereas comparatively the truck will go fast. Okay, So please try to understand. Now, taking this fight and load, the car is being stressed. Okay, so it can reach only a maximum speed of, imagine, 40 kilometers per hour. Like it, 40 kmph. I'll just expand this window. Okay. Whereas the truck can reach up to 70 kmph. Okay. Now please understand, load is how much can it take. Okay. And stress is how long can it take that load. Okay. For how long can it take that load. Okay. I will give you an assignment today. I'll tell you to submit it tomorrow. Okay. That is a load. Now I'll give you two assignments today. I'll tell you to submit it day after tomorrow. Now I'll give you 10 assignments today and I'll tell you to submit it after 3 days. Okay. So please try to understand. Load is different. Load is how much you are burdening the system. Stress is taking that load, how fast or how far can the system move. Okay, so I hope you understood what is load and stress. Both are together. Load is the actual load. Okay, how much load are you giving? Okay, can it lift it or not? Can it move that load or not? And stress is for how long can it move it? Okay, in hot sun, I'll give you 25 kg bag. Okay, and I'll ask you to run in a field. I'll see how far can you...
Problem with your voice, sir?
You have a problem with my voice, ma'am? Now it's okay, ma'am? Is my voice okay, ma'am?
Okay.
Okay, so I hope you understood what is load and stress. So coming to software, so load will become the number of users. The number of users will become the load, and stress is going to become for how long can the server, okay, most probably we are going to use this load test, stress test for a server. So for how long can it take that load, okay, until it breaks. Okay, so that is the difference between load and stress. That is why we are going to use this tool Apache JMeter to test it out. Okay, so now how do we use this tool? Very easy. So we have a test plan over here already ready. So in syllabus, if you see test plan, okay, so you'll understand that this is the test plan what we are trying to create. Okay, so you have to right click this test plan, add. Yeah, before I go further, I forgot to ask you a question. So now we are about to load test and stress, something like a server. Now, why do you want to do this? Why? So please understand, to know how much load know how much load the server can take, and of course to get to know the performance. You can use it to get to know how much load or how many users the server can take, and you also get to know the performance of the server. Okay, so now my question is, why should I use this tool? Okay, because From where will you get 1,000 users? Or from where will you get forget about 1000. Let me talk about a real time value. From where will you get 100 users? Where will I get 100 users? It's not possible, right? I want to test something. From where will I get 100 users? It's not possible. So for that, we are using this tool. This tool can simulate our J-meter, can simulate your users. Okay, it will simulate the users for a given period of time. Okay, or it can be infinite also. Okay, now let me tell you something. Please, this is a very important point. It is not ethical to test a web server, or not web server, any server without permissions. Please mark it in bold that it is not ethical to test a server without permissions. Okay, why? Because see, I'm trying to simulate 100 users or 1000 users, 10,000 users or 1 lakh users. Okay, it is being done from your system, right? So unnecessarily you are trying to test without the permission. Now it will lead to something called, as I hope you know this, DOS attack. Okay, so you should not do it. I hope all of you know what is ethical, right? You know, ethical hacker, right? So he takes permissions from the organization and he does the job. Okay, now if you don't take permission and if you try to do this testing on a server, it will be treated as a DOS attack. Okay, so I hope you know what is DOS attack. Okay, I hope your computer networks, I guess, somewhere this attack is mentioned. Okay, so it is not ethical. Okay, you should take permission. Okay, but for academic purpose, like, some limitations are there. A limit you should not break when you are using this tool. Okay, so now let's go to the J-meter. The first thing you do is, here on the top you have a test plan. So the first thing we do is create the users, right? So here, in order to create the users, we are going to add something called as a thread group. Okay, a thread group. Okay, in the thread group you have some important parameters. This one, number of users, then the ramp up period and the loop count. Don't keep it forever. Forever means in infinite loop. It's not to keep it forever. Okay, you should have some count. Now why should we have some count over here is, there's a particular reason. See, if you want to calculate performance, you should know these values. If I keep it infinite and stop it in between, I cannot compute properly. Okay, without these parameters. Okay, now let me just show you why. So I'll just take an example. So just see on the top. So this is number of threads or users. So this is users. Okay, then I take an Excel sheet. That will be better. How is the attendance, ma'am? I can't see the attendance.
113, and there's a doubt from 29.
There's a doubt.
One test performance of some site, and can't it be shown in server?
Why should one test performance of the site, can't it be shown in server to people who manage the site? Yeah, Ritik always has this question. See, you test the site to know the performance. Why should one?
What is test performance? See,
if you want to show the performance of a server, you have to test it. I hope the question is solved. See, please, if you want to test, if you want to get to know the performance of the server, of course you need to test. I don't want to prolong that question and answer.
continue continue
yeah so let me see like users and then I have the ramp up period so RUP is ramp up period and then I have the loop count so this is the loop count so whatever you are seeing on the top over here I'm trying to manipulate over here so imagine I give so already it is written as one user one second as a ramp up period and I have one loop count so the number of samples that are going to become are one so how did I get this one so I got it by multiplying users multiplied by loop count so imagine lc is loop count so this is loop count okay so I got it by users multiplied by loop count okay so let me make it 10 users one is the ramp up period in seconds and then loop count is 1 then samples is users into loop count 10 okay I hope you understood this point let me make ramp up period 2 seconds loop count is 2 sorry 1 my samples will be 10 so you might get a doubt then what is the use of this ramp up period okay because it is not affecting my samples no it won't affect ramp up period doesn't affect the number of samples these are number of samples but it will affect ramp up period will affect your performance okay so samples is users into loop count please understand let me mark so samples is users into loop count okay but if you want to know the actual performance then comes ramp up period okay there is a difference between 10 users requesting the server within 1 second where the server needs to manage where the server needs to manage so let me tell that it has to manage 10 users in 1 second it become in 1 second it has to manage 10 users right whereas here in 2 seconds it has to manage 10 users okay please try to understand so the amount of time allotted for one request over here is less to handle the request so this is like to handle request okay to handle the request here in this scenario where 10 users come in 1 second the amount of time for the server to handle that request is less whereas when 10 users come in 2 seconds you have more time to handle the users you have double the time compared okay I can't tell it as more you have some 0.1 more okay you got 0.1 more per request okay so that is the difference okay so samples come using users multiplied by loop count and the performance comes from the users and the ramp up period okay because it will give you the amount of time required to handle the request okay I hope you understood this point and I'm going further okay yeah so number of 111 students I hope that point is clear yeah. Now the number of threads here I'm going to take it as 10 I'll try to increase it later okay so 10 requests in 1 second has to be handled by the server and I'm not continuing the loop it is only for one iteration next to this thread group we are going to add a sampler which is a http request okay so to the thread group we add a sampler which is a http request. You have other samplers also, but we in the syllabus are going with HTTP request. Okay, so here you have a lot of parameters to discuss about. So let's start with the most easiest one, which is the server name. Okay, now the server name or IP, both are different. Let me tell you over here. I'll give you an example actually. If you go with server name, it has to, you know the computer network basics. So if you go with server name, it will go to the domain name. Yes, domain name has to be resolved, and then you go to the IP address. So there is a backdrop over there. So your testing is not accurate. Okay, if you go with IP address, it is good. Okay. Yes. So for example, I give google.com. What will happen if I give google.com? So when I give google.com, it will go to the DNS. It has to resolve google.com. Okay. So it has to find the server which is DNS to IP. Yeah, it has to find the, not only that, when you give google.com, it is not actually the correct domain name which I'm giving. So it will be transferred to a correct Google server. Okay, not only the IP address is being resolved. If I give IP address directly, it will go to the exact server. Please understand, if you type google.com, it is not going to google.com. I hope you understand. Okay, it will go to google.co.in based on your location preference. Okay, so this is also not correct. Why? I'll show you. Okay, so but still now I'm using google.com. Next comes port number. By default HTTP, the port number is 80. Okay, but because it's a default port number, you don't need to mention. Okay, but if you are testing something like in web technologies, you are using Apache Tomcat at 8080, then you have to mention it. Okay, then you have to mention. That means if your server is not using the default port, it is using some other port, then you have to mention it. If it is 80, you don't need to mention it. Okay, then comes the timeout. Okay, there are two things in timeout. It is a very confusing topic again, but let me explain you in a very easy manner. Based on these two parameters, okay, you are going to calculate the overall response time. Okay, so what is connect, what is response, you need to understand. Okay, that, let me just go to a small example. So this is my Ookla. So Ookla, everyone knows Ookla, so I came to this Ookla speed test. So what you see over here, this ping what you see is what is our connect. Okay, so please try to understand, this ping is what is our connect. Of course, this has nothing to do with our topic. It only tests how fast data is being transferred. Okay, so this ping, I'm talking about this ping. Okay, how fast you can connect. Here it is written 25. Okay, but sometimes it might not be 25. Okay, so you need to give some time for that ping. Okay, so this is one point. And another point, let me just show you. I'll test my own local host. So like ping 127.0.0.1. Now you get some parameters. Now you see some parameters. Okay. Now here, yeah. So this is what you see is the response time from the, how much time did the server take to respond back. See, it is a local loopback. So of course it is very fast. Okay. Now this also changes because I'm busy with other softwares on the computer. So it has to give preference, okay, operating system topics, okay, giving priority to processes. Okay, so based on that, see, it is changing. This is the response time, it is changing. And this TTL, I hope you know in computer networks, it is the time to live. So it has given this amount of time to live. If it is going to cross, I hope you know what is going to happen, the packet is going to die. The packet doesn't die. Someone who gets the packet will just destroy it. Okay. So what is TTL? You can go through the definition in Google. It means time to live. Okay. Which you already know in computer network. So that is what the parameters we are going to set over here. Okay. but don't worry, I'm just explaining, but for our lab we are not going to use the parameters. Okay, next is the implementation method. Now this JMeter inbuilt has some implementation methods of how to connect. Now we are least bothered about them. Okay, might be in future if you become a load and stress tester full time, you'll use it. Okay, and then you have protocol. Now HTTP is not only the protocol for the World Wide Web. I hope you know that apart from HTTP, there are some protocols meant for World Wide Web. Like we have HTTPS. Sorry. You can use HTTPS. Of course, you have FTP also. I hope you know most of you download some softwares. It will go to FTP, a site, mirror site, which is in FTP. Okay. So if it is not HTTP, but still it is based on HTTP request, that server can handle HTTP request and the protocol used is different, then you'll mention the protocol over here. For now, it is not required. Next comes is the method. So I hope you know in web programming, you have seen these methods, HTTP methods. Okay. If you don't know, you can just go to the W3 schools. I hope you know W3 schools is the schools for World Wide Web. Okay. It is from World Wide Web Consortium. This is World Wide Web Consortium. They are maintaining it. So you need to know these are the HTTP methods. I hope you know, you are taught in web programming. Okay, those are the methods. Next comes encoding, content encoding. It is very easy. When you save a file, it saves the content, a text content, using some encoding technique like ANSI, ASCII. I hope I discussed this topic earlier. So where do you find encoding, content encoding in a server? So I'll just, we'll open some site. So this is the, W3C, World Wide Web Consortium. So they are talking about declaring character encodings in HTML. How should we declare? Okay, this is the standard. Okay, so we are using a meta tag. Okay, and you set the encoding type for the characters. Here it is UTF-8. Okay, if you want to see it live, let me just open some website. Even Google will do. So I'll just see the page source of Google, and you'll find it. You'll find it in, yeah, it's over here. The meta character set UTF-8. So it is using UTF-8. Okay. So if you are using any other standards, okay, you have to mention it over here. Okay. This is for Google. Okay. The Google basic page. Okay. So you have to mention it over there. That is what W3 consortium says. So that should be mentioned over here. So by default for our lab, we are not using it. So good for you. Next comes the path. So path is, you don't want to test google.com. Instead of testing google.com, you want to test google.com/something else. For example, let me see. So I don't want to test w3schools.com. I want to test w3schools.com/this path. Okay, so I'll just copy it. If this is w3schools.com, then the path will be like this. Okay, that means I don't want to test the server, but I want to test some page on the server, a particular path, not a page, a particular path. Then I'll give w3schools.com over here and the path to my page, particular page or particular content over here. So for the lab, by default, we are not using it. Okay. Very good. So there are some other settings which are not required for the lab. Okay. So I'm skipping it off. And next, for example, there's one important thing we need to see is send parameters with the request. So for this, again, what is this name and value? You already know in your web programming. So name is name of the HTML element and value. So if you want to send the name and value using this HTTP request automatically. So let me show you an example. So here I have a search bar. So I'll keep search and then just go to, so if I want to apply this content, something like HTML over here, or let me change it to PHP because we are already on HTML. So PHP, and I'll click on search. Right now, what happens? I want to test this part. Okay, so I have to do PHP and search. Okay, so if I want to do this part, first of all, I have to inspect this element to get its value. So I'll inspect the element. So this is the element. Now I need to get the name of this element. This is the name of the element. The name of the element is search. And what is the value? The value is something you are going to type over here. You know the basics, right? The HTML basics. So the name of this is search. Okay, name of this input element is search, and PHP is the value what you want to send for search. So what you are going to do over here is, you'll, if this is W3 schools, if this is W3 schools, we'll just add, okay, we'll just add a name. So name is search, and then value is PHP. Okay, right? Yeah. Right, the value is PHP. Now this is going to be W3 schools. Okay, please understand. Okay, I hope you got the point. Okay, now I'm deleting it. Okay, next, if you have MIME types like file uploads, okay, then this is your file path which you can set. Okay, we don't have it in the lab, but I'm just conveying this message. If you are getting internet and you have a proxy server, then you are going to use a proxy server, the IP address, port name, username, password. Okay, I guess that is sufficient for our lab. Okay, so next we'll go forward. So next, for this HTTP request, so for the test plan, we added a thread group. For the thread group, we added a HTTP request. Now to this HTTP request, we are going to add a listener. There are many listeners over here. Okay, you can try out, there are many listeners, okay, but let's see some listeners, okay, some examples of some listeners. Okay, why do we use such listeners? So let me go with the first one, which is aggregate graph. Okay, I'm just clicking on aggregate graph. So this is aggregate graph. Okay, of course I got aggregate results also over here. Graph will come after I get the results. Okay, now if you want to get these average time for the request, median time for the request, 90% line, which, how many requests have crossed the 90% mark? That means the number of requests which are similar, okay, 90%. And then you have min and max, minimum time taken for the, minimum time taken for the all the requests. What is the, which request got the minimum time and maximum time? Okay, now just you need to go to the top and click on start. Okay, now once you start, it will start sending 10 requests in 1 second. So that is 10 requests in 1 second is I gave you the calculation in the Excel sheet. Okay, so I'll just click on play. Okay, I'm not saving it, but it's better if you save it. Okay, I'm just clicking on no. Okay, so 10 requests are done. It is still running the threads. Yeah, my threads are run. Now I got, as per the calculation, I got 10 requests. This is the average, median, 90%, minimum, maximum, no errors. This is my throughput. Okay, so this throughput says that it can in 51.9 per minute, like as per my settings, it can handle these requests. And this is the amount of data being sent to the server. Okay, now if I just click on display graph, see, this is my graph. Okay, so this is red is average, it's shown over here on the bottom, the legend is on the bottom. Okay, right, this is the median, 90% similarity, all maximum, like 90% things happened like this. This is the minimum and this is the maximum. These are in milliseconds. This is for your reference. It is in milliseconds. Okay. Now if you want to clear off this data, we'll just clear it off. Okay. Now aggregate graph is showing you that for 10 samples, this is the data. Okay. Now, but for which sample, for example, for sample one, what is the data? For sample two, what is the data? If you want to get it individually, you need to add a different listener. Okay, before you add a different listener, you have to click on clear. Okay, it will clear only average aggregate graph. It's better you use this, that is clear all. Okay, like you have multiple listeners and all the data has to be cleared. You can't click everything and click and clear. So clear all. Okay, so HTTP request, right click. I'm adding another listener this time to know each and every request in detail, a little bit in detail, one step closer. So for that, I'm going for view results in table. Okay, view results in table. Okay, now let me run the test. Now you'll understand. This is giving you aggregate graph. Okay, of course, this part what you see over here, you see this part, right? Okay, this part will, this part is not aggregate graph. This part is summary results. Okay, I'll show you summary results also. Okay, so we want this in detail. I'm just running it. We are waiting for the responses. Yeah. So now you see that, now you see that you got each and every sample data. Okay. You got each and every sample data. Okay. Now, very good, sir. I got each and every sample data, the starting time, the thread group. Okay, actually, if you see, actually the 10th thread came back first. I hope you understood. 10th thread, this is the 10th thread, which came back first. 5th thread came second. It is like in a running race, 10 people went. Okay, the 10th fellow came first, the 5th came second. Okay, anyway, I hope you understood. Yeah, now I want to know in detail what happened to sample one, in detail, what was sent in detail. So for that, what you can do is, first of all, let me clear everything, cleared everything. For that, you are going to use another listener. Okay, that is called as view results tree. Okay, here you'll get everything in detail. So let me play. So 10 threads created, sent to the server. Now the server needs to respond to the 10 threads. Yeah, it has responded. Everything is done. Now see, for each thread, you get this data in detail. This is the sampler result. Okay, don't ask me what is inside over here. What is all this, please? Okay, you are going to become the testers of the future. Then you can tell me. Okay, then this is the request which was sent. Request is very easy. Okay, just a small request. And this is the response data. So this is actually the HTML file. I hope you understood. The response data is the HTML file. I hope you can see doc type HTML and all this. Okay. Now what happened to this request? You can just expand here in the corner. So actually we requested for google.com, right? So once we requested for google.com, what actually happened? See what actually happened? You got a 301. That means it is being, the document is not here, but the document is somewhere else. That is what it's saying. So actually it went to www.google.com. So when you type google.com in your browser, don't think that it is going to www.google.com. That is the beauty of the browser and the servers. Okay. They are transferring you behind. So next time when you type, I hope you understood the importance of typing www.google.com. Okay. Only testers know that you should not use domain names. It is better you use IP address. Okay. Because for resolving this, it is going to waste some time. Okay. So for every request you'll get. So this is for results tree. Okay, I hope you understood. This is like overall. Okay, you'll get aggregate graph in another fashion. This table on the top, this table. Okay, you'll also get it with, like you only want the table, you'll get summary report. Let me just show you summary report. Like you only get the report. You won't get that graph and everything. okay, you only get this table. Okay, aggregate graph means he'll show this table and a graph to map with. Okay, I hope you understood. So every listener has its importance. Okay, don't think that one listener is good and another listener is bad. No, each listener has its own importance. Okay, so let me see, like there is something called response time graph. This is another important one. So this is like the response time graph. It doesn't go with it needs more data. I'll just show you. It needs more data. It cannot go with just 10 samples. It needs more data to compute the response time. So we finished getting the data. We got this data. Now we'll just go to response time graph and display graph. Now you'll get this error. Unable to graph, you don't have enough data. So what we do is we'll go back to the thread group and make this as 100. Okay, now you got kind of more data and 100 requests in 1 second. Let's see what will happen. So now run it. So done. Of course, here you'll see that there's a problem because we sent 100. So there's a problem in response time. So just go to response time graph, display on display graph. Oh, still there is not enough data. Okay, no problem. We'll run the results again. Now please observe this time, I'm continuing the same samples. Okay, or else I'll just change it to 1000 in 10 seconds. I'll clear everything. 1000 is too many requests. I don't know whether if I send too many requests again, I'll be blocked. 1000 is too much. Okay, no problem. We'll see what will happen. 1000 is too much. The performance will go down. See, throughput was per minute. Now it became per second. Yes, of course, we'll get bad averages. I guess it is taking time to run because 1000 is too high a value. And in response time graph, you'll get only one dot. I have to run it more number of times to get the response time graph. So this is how it comes, and you need to continue it till 215. I hope you know that this 215 has to come to zero. 215 requests are still kept pending. It didn't get the response back. Okay. Meanwhile, you can also add another listener. There's something called as a spline visualizer, which will show you a live graph. Okay. I have to run it when I have to stop and run it from the beginning, then you'll get it. I guess we got all the results, and all the results are bad. So this is how your response time graph comes. So this is for one test. This will be for the next test. So let me break it down to 100 in 10 seconds. Run it again. So this is your spline visualizer, which is like, it shows live how performance is happening in live. Like sometimes you need it in live. So this you have to display again. So this is how things happen. Okay. So that's it. That's about how people want their reports regarding to do such load and stress testing, as I told you, without permissions. Any doubts, please ask. Yes, any doubts, please ask. Because I got to know that placements from 7 o'clock session is arranged. So please, if you have any doubts, please ask. Yashasvini is having a smile on her face. I don't know why. Yes, it's better instead of giving your name and roll number, if you are following standards, you can just wish good morning, sorry, good evening, because we'll get good evening over here, and your roll number and name, of course, will come over here by default. Nothing to worry. Yeah. Ma'am, is someone online? I'm not getting any feedback.
No one.
No doubts.
Yes, no doubts.
No doubts.
No doubts.
Surprising Sayas, no doubt.
Rehman is saying good evening. Now.
Yashasvini wants to share a doubt. I don't know why her video is on. Do you want to share a doubt, Amma Yashasvini? 87.
She didn't hear.
Ma'am?
She didn't hear what you said.
I guess her speaker is off. She doesn't know that her camera is recording.
Let's know what something Fayaz is saying.
Fayaz is saying?
But will you let know Pakka if I have any doubts? Okay. If he has a doubt, he will ask.
No, he doesn't have any doubts. Now, if he has any, he'll let you know.
Sure, but please do let us know that in future some of you become testers. You'll help us in this teaching this tool a bit better.
What is ping?
What is ping? Very good, Ritik. You please ask who is your computer networks? Ritik is first section. Madam, who is teaching computer networks first section?
First section, computer networks, I think Vikram sir. Vikram sir, yeah. Vikram Narayan.
See, ping is not speed of internet, please. Ping is not speed of internet. Akhil Kare sir.
Yeah, okay. Kare sir. Kare sir. Yeah.
I can answer the question, but if your computer networks faculty answer, it will be better.
Time yes, taken to reach
is, yeah. Yes, yes, yes. Now Rohan is correcting the answer. Typically ping means speed of internet, but not, of course we use ping. Ping is part of testing, but ping is what I'll go with Aditya. Now Fayaz is going too personal. Fayaz is going with ping as a command. Now my question is, Ritik, did you ask ping as a command or ping as a attribute?
Sir, Kaushik has a question again. He has recently acquired domain from freenom.com. Can I know it gets IP? No, it gets its IP address. How to get its IP address, right?
You just need to type IP checker. So you just need to write something like google.com. And then there you go, you'll get your IP address. This is how you check, Kaushik. I hope I answered your question. Okay, you have to go for IP checker. Okay, type your domain here. Okay, and then you get your IP address. I hope the doubt is cleared. Yeah, but it is a computer networks doubt. This is a software engineering class.
Okay, sir.
No problem. Yeah, Ritik still doesn't answer. Yeah. Any more doubt? I guess this placement said that 7 o'clock. There's a Manikanta. What is a proxy server? Sorry, it's purely computer networks. Please ask.
Why everybody asking questions related to computer networks?
Because in JMeter we had proxy in the bottom. Over
okay,
here.
So proxy server. So that is okay, fine.
So, like sometimes you won't get internet directly to your computer. Most probably in institutions they have a proxy in between, okay, which will manage like they don't want you to go to Facebook, okay. So they'll manage all that in a proxy, okay. Or they'll using VPNs, okay. Then they'll use a proxy, virtual private network. Then they might use a proxy, okay. So Aditya is saying that. He wants you to answer. Yeah. Ritik doesn't answer whether he wanted the ping as a command or ping as an attribute.
He said attribute.
Ping as an attribute. Yes, I showed it him in Ookla. The time taken for that connectivity. Of course, it's also used for getting to know the speed of your connection. One of the attribute to know the speed of the connection. So half Aditya's answer and half Faya's answer. Yeah, I hope it is done. Then we'll leave. The count is going down again, madam. Anyway,
yes.
We'll conclude the session. Tomorrow we'll have user interface. So you have the golden rule. Very important. Go through this video and go through these videos. Okay.
Interface and design also very important.
Yes, ma'am. So I'll not teach you what is exactly in the handouts. I'll try to teach you practically, okay, like taking a practical example, because there's no use now. You see the same videos, the same handouts are given to you. I think you need to know the actual concepts. So ma'am, we are closing the session now.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, students. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, everyone. I'm not able to run JMeter, Aditya.
Good, Aditya. Good.